it's still not distinct yet.
Hey, watch out. Any vessel anywhere around?
What do I do now? Okay, no. Oh, stress. Should we show off our table? This table can go up. Wow.
Okay, this is your first mission.
Okay, thank you. Wow, where is this? I really don't know where is this. Is it like the Fort Canning or something? Okay, so I just googled. Is it called the Raffles House? Yeah. Raffles House is a single-story building built on Fort Canning Hill, Singapore. Okay, so we're going to Sir Stamford Raffles Old House. Drum roll. Don't have eh, but I got Sir Stamford Raffles Waffles.
Ang Mo Kio.
Hey, you better tell me eh. If not, later you need to walk. Now we are heading to... where again? Fort Canning Lighthouse.
Do you think we need to climb?
Feels like we need to climb eh. But then it's on Grab eh. So technically it should take us there eh.
And drive you on top
eh. Yeah. Walao! I reached the top, then you asked me to walk one more time. I actually went up once already, but the producer asked me to come down again, as if it's not early enough already. Okay, let's see the clue again. The clue is, in front of Sir Stamford Raffles Old House. Ah, eh, do you see Raffles House there? Yeah, okay, we are going to Raffles House. Hello, and we are here. That's Sir Stamford Raffles Old House. Yeah, and over here we have the Fort Canning Lighthouse. Yay! Mission 1 complete. We have reached the lighthouse. Mission 2, let's go. Hello, and now we are at the top of Fort Canning, and today we are going to meet someone here.
Hi. I'm Kenneth, I'm overseeing the Singapore Maritime Gallery. Kaien, do you know why we are starting our field trip here, particularly at Fort Canning?
I have no idea.
Fort Canning Hill is one of the highest hills in Singapore, which has a very advantageous view of the port.
So Kenneth, this is the Fort Canning Lighthouse?
Actually, this is not the actual lighthouse. This is a replica of the lighthouse. The lighthouse was actually operational from 1903 up to the 1950s. But it no more had an unobstructed view of the harbour. So a decision has been made to decommission this lighthouse and shift the function of the lighthouse to the top of the General Post Office.
Okay, let me guess, 5 lighthouses. Fort Canning Lighthouse, that's definitely one. I think there's a Raffles Lighthouse. Then, I don't know already.
Wow, so clever, but must chop you lah.
Okay.
Fort Canning Lighthouse cannot be included, discounted.
Okay.
So the 5 lighthouses, they are Raffles, Horsburgh, Sultan Shoal, Bedok, and one more, Pulau Pisang. Your wish is granted. Look, the beautiful 5 models of the lighthouses that Singapore maintains.
So where are we now?
Oh, we are at the Singapore Maritime Gallery. This is a place where a person can learn about maritime developments. Even before Raffles founding, shipping has always been the lifeblood of Singapore. And through the founding with Raffles, that accelerated this whole economy of our nation. As of now, at any one time, there are 1,000 ships in the port of Singapore. In a year, total of 130,000 ships ply by the port of Singapore. Over 80%, almost all of the things, whatever I have, whatever I order, are being bought in by container vessels.
Fun fact, your arm span is almost equivalent to your height. I'm about 1.8 meters tall, so I'm gonna measure the container now. So Kenneth, for the longest voyages, they take about up to 2 weeks. Are there any petrol kiosks in the sea? How do they refuel?
They are not really permanent floating petrol kiosks in the sea, what we have are bunkering tankers. Bunkering is the process of supplying fuel to a vessel.
Singapore is always like very good at a lot of things, right? Like, is bunkering considered like to have very high standards in Singapore?
You are asking the million-dollar question.
You are a million bucks! You are a million bucks!
Again, so intelligent, this my guess, hit it in the nail. Singapore handles the largest volume of marine fuel, or equals to bunkers means marine fuel, in the world. We have been tops for the last more than 10 years.
Okay, yes. Let's do it. Okay, final mission. OGS tries. Navigate a ship through a storm. Oh my god. Cannot call the helicopter come. They have a search and rescue helicopter. Yeah, I'll bring all of you to safety, man. Too easy.
I'm gonna crash.
No, I'm not gonna crash. See, it's passing by. Wow, stress. Stress.
Too easy.
But I think we can get out.
4 minutes
It's all in your mind. We are reaching. You see the two buoys there? I think we are supposed to go into the middle of it. We are not supposed to hit it, lah. So of course you go through it, right?
Turning.
Yeah, we are turning in. Oh my god, you really must turn in, eh? This game is so difficult. Wow, this game really never give chance. Yeah! It's a success! 2 stars, okay? There was a time when people said that I cannot make it. But I did. As you can see here, it's a mission success. It's quite a difficult game actually. And they really made it in such a way whereby you have just enough time to complete the mission. Kind of, so I finished the game. Guess whether I managed to...
You managed to succeed it?
I got 2 stars.
Really?
Yeah.
Well done, man. 5, I think.
Kenneth, so thank you for showing me like around the whole day. What is one last thing that you want like people to remember about like Maritime?
One of the most important message is all visitors to the gallery must come to the awareness of how important the maritime sector is, not only for our nation, but personally for us.
I think the favourite part of the field trip today was definitely the ship simulator, where we got to save the OGS crew. Yeah, so that's definitely fun, and I think it's something that everyone should try. Most people don't know much about the maritime industry. We are the people who actually benefit from it, like getting our food, getting our online orders, but most of the time we don't look at it just because it's not the most accessible thing, but we should definitely learn more about it because this is what keeps the Singapore economy going.
I crashed.